done, my friend.
I appreciate you. How about this beautiful trophy? Huh? Hey, I got some wise words for that Cincinnati mayor. Know your role and shut your mouth, you jabroni.
Welcome back to TMZ Sports, Mike and Mojo. Mojo, I've been waiting to talk to you about this since last night when Travis Kelce went full WWE after the Chiefs beat the Bengals in the AFC Championship game. We talked about the Burrowhead stuff last week. It all started when the Bengals cornerback, Mike Hilton, after they beat the Bills the week before, in a moment of excitement, he said Burrowhead had nothing but success at Arrowhead prior to yesterday's game. But then, and this is me speaking here, then the idiotic mayor from Cincinnati started talking all of that crap when he's not the one going out there making any tackles or playing any sort of football. And Travis Kelce, Mojo, let him have it after the game.
Was this a better rivalry than the Bengals and Chiefs, like, yeah. on the actual field?
Yeah. Who knew?
The rivalry with the mayor of the city? Because it certainly seemed that way. I mean, the first chance they got to speak about the game, they went right for the mayor and went right after the Burrowhead comments. Babcock, we talked last week about how much of a motivator that statement would be.
Yeah.
Any kind of doubt, any questions were immediately answered with every single post-game interview. It was the first thing that was mentioned with every single question. So you know it was the only thing on the bulletin board all week. That being said, yeah, I agree with you, my friend. The mayor coming out and chiming in on the fun and throwing in the who's your daddy line. Maybe not his place to throw salt on an open wound, right, kind of thing. Dude, hearing everything Travis Kelce said afterwards, this is why he is one of my favorite players in the entire league. The hype levels are always off the charts. Totally abducted the Mahomes interview. Just took that thing right over. You know I appreciate the wrestling references.
Yeah.
Right up my alley. I'm going to be honest with you, Babcock. I'm a little shocked that as of now, The Rock hasn't responded to this, but I will bet any money in the world that that response is coming. Dwayne is super active on social media, loves interacting with fans and other celebrity athletes, especially when they use some of his taglines, because that was obviously Kelce.
Right. Well, Mojo, if let's do this. If people are not familiar and you're kind of a football fan, you're wondering what the heck of Travis Kelce was saying up there on the podium, it'll make a lot more sense. Check this out.
Hey, I got some wise words for that Cincinnati mayor. Know your role and shut your mouth, you jabroni. If you're the mayor, what the Rock? You gotta fight for your right to party.
Mojo, you know what it takes to make it in WWE. Is Travis Kelce, when he's done playing football, or maybe before then, will he be a professional wrestler?
I mean, he certainly could be if he wanted to. I mean, he's got the mic skills. Even with his podcast that he's doing now with his brother, he's demonstrated, you know, he can handle the mic in all different ways. I don't know, man. I might give him a 9.5 out of 10 on that promo, and I'm taking off a half point here because I think he may have forgotten the second line to The Rock's tagline here. You know, he totally missed an opportunity on the tongue roll with the if you smell. He could have said what the Chiefs were cooking. He delivered the Beastie Boys line, you know, you got to fight for your right to party. I thought that was out of place. I wasn't sure exactly why that was worked in there. My hunch is that he just forgot the Rock slide and just had to fill in something there.